What if I told you, you don't need to open up Adobe After Effects anymore to do some simple yet super awesome animations? Well, we all know this feeling where you want to animate a text or you want to animate a shape, you want to add some nice bounce effects to it or anything like that. Usually you had to open up Adobe After Effects, do some animations, export them into Adobe Premiere Pro, and yeah, that workflow is just very tedious, and in the end you don't end up doing animations at all because it's just taking way too much time. In today's video, I'm gonna be showing you how that actually is possible in Adobe Premiere Pro. Hey, what's up, ladies and gentlemen? I'm Ignace, Aleya, and today I have another tutorial, this time about animation inside of Adobe Premiere Pro. Really, that's something. I'm doing this video in collaboration with Smash Workshop, and the only reason I am collaborating with them is because I believe this is a game changer. I'm gonna be using this from now on, so it looks super awesome. Let's dive into it. All right, so here you can see I have this little scene set up in Premiere Pro, all animated in Premiere Pro. And the fun thing is, it even takes less time than if I would animate it in Adobe After Effects, because usually you need expressions, you need keyframing. This is all keyframeless, or you can keyframe a few things, but this, you don't need any keyframes in order to do any of these animations that I've done here. And it just looks so amazing. Right, so you have tons of functionalities. This is Smashworks Animation Builder. Let's see how it works. So the first thing you want to do is go in Premiere Pro and go on the tabs right here, and you see graphics. I think that graphics is the better choice to work in. If you don't see that, you can go to Window, Workspaces, Graphics right here. Basically, all you need is the Essential Graphics tab here. So you can also just bring that up. And then you go to the Browse function. The first thing you want to do is import, of course, all of their products. So I'm going to import a motion graphics template. And this is what is included in the pack. So you have a bonus pack, custom image, shape builder, and text builder. The bonus pack is basically arrows, which you can animate, which is really cool if you do a lot of infomercials or just if you want to use arrows. Custom image is a really cool one. So I'm going to import the custom image later. I'm going to import my shape builder because we're going to be using that right now. And I'm going for the HD version as, yeah, 4K is gonna load a little bit too long, but this is actually a 4K composition here. So I'm going to open up this version, Shape Builder, and then next the Text Builder. Okay, great. So the first thing that I wanna do is create a new sequence. So let's go ahead and do that. I will go to the settings and make it Full HD. And there we go. So now I wanna create a new color mat. Okay, I'm just gonna pick like a nice dark purplish kind of color for the background, a little bit desaturated. And there we go for that space look. And I'm gonna bring that in here, make it a little bit longer. And the first thing that I wanna do is actually dive into the text part, which is really awesome. All the functionalities that you have in there. You can make a super professional title within seconds, which I didn't even know this was possible when I first got the pack, but it kept surprising me as I went on using it. So that's really cool. Okay, so I import that in my scene on top of my background. It's loading in. And what you can see is here the interface. If you don't see it on your screen, you can square the aspect ratio. And basically that gives you all of the information that you're currently working on. So you have the duration, the speed, the ease of the style, how it stops. The animation is position and the direction it's going. For example, if I go now and change the direction, just to give you an example, it will go up. So that's really, really nice. So that's a good way to know how it's going to be kind of animating in or out. And there we go. So before exporting, you can turn this off, but actually I prefer to turn it off right away because I kind of understand the tools. It's really good for beginners to have like a guide on how they should be working, but I immediately understood it because I'm kind of familiar with Adobe Premiere Pro and After Effects. So I'm going to check this off so I can concentrate on my final design. So right away, if I play it, we see that we have text moving up and coming to a slow stop with the easy ease effect. So I'm going to change this and write explore the galaxy. Cool. Next, we can choose the style here. so we can animate nothing, the position or the scale. And actually I like how it is animating the position right here, but I'm going to set it to none because I'm going to be doing a different kind of animation on my text later on. So I do like the ease, but I do like overshoot a lot more. So if we do that, we just drag this over to the next option. Right here you can see the numbers, and numbers provide each effect. You can do an overshoot, bounce, or a continuous. Continuous is that it keeps looping over and over again. But there we go. That looks really cool with the overshoot. You can also play with the speed. Maybe we want to make it a little bit lower, so it's a little bit slower. And there we go. And you can also play with the duration right here. So I think I like this animation for now. Now I want to concentrate on all the other tools here. Here we have the text settings. We have the line spacing, the letter spacing. I'm going to check if I would like to have some letter spacing. Maybe I do, but then I have to play with the size again a little bit, like so. Okay, there we go. We can close this, go into the text box mode. We can add a box to the text, which is really cool because I really enjoy adding a box to my text. It makes it look more professional in some ways, and it's also more readable. So it's really nice that it just kind of adapts to the length of my sentence. And then we can play with the box size, of course, in the height. We can also round the corners, which is also really cool. Like this. You can add an outline effect if you want to. It's completely up to you. And there we go. So I'm going to close this again. And now for the text reveal. If we open this, we can choose how the text is going to appear. This is just a simple animation. But I want it to kind of come in as a typewriter. So then I will go to one. And it's writing in like this. You can also do a fade in or a grow in or anything like that. And you can also choose if you wanted to kind of fade in by character or by word or by line. So that's completely up to you. So you have a lot of functionality over all the animations, and it's super easy to follow with this. So you also have a secondary animation, and what this does is just some kind of continuous movement. If you want a little bit more of a dynamicness in your shot, what you can do is enable the secondaries and then animate the position, for example, random, and we can lower the speed quite a lot, and then with the distance we can keep it as it is, but then you'll see what it will do. It will randomly just move our box over the place here. So that's a little bit too much, of course, it's just an example, so you can lower these values quite a lot, but then you have some kind of subtle animation in there, and that keeps the entire composition alive. Okay, so I like this one here, that looks cool, great. Animation options, you have the position reverse, a jello mode, which is also really cool if you're working with shapes, for example. The use of motion blur, I would only check this on at the end of your animation because it does lower the speed of the software, which is completely normal. But yeah, that will add a little bit more of a realistic effect to your movements. So once you're done and once you're ready to render, just check on this box and then you will have motion blur, which you can see right here. So if we go here, it's quite sharp, but it's actually a movement. So if we're gonna check on the motion blur, we're gonna get a more realistic look to that. So just check it on when you're ready to export. Then you have the character expand here, which will just expand your text slowly or faster, however you want over time. Again, to add animation in there, a fade in effect, a rotation in effect. Let's try this one. How cool is that? Damn, that's I didn't even test it before this tutorial, but that's really cool. Wow. All right, so this is really cool. We have our text set. Now what we want to do is add some stars in our shot. So we can actually do this with the shape here. So if we go back to the top here and we go to browse, we can bring in our shape builder, bring that on top here. Let's solo this for now so we can concentrate on our shape. So just disable the text. And I'm going to disable my interface. I'm going into the size, make it right, smaller. And then right here we see ellipse, rectangle, polygon, star. So we're going for a star. Cool. And then for the shape color, we can choose some kind of orangish kind of color. Like this, kind of bronze. And in this, we want to use an ease. The speed is okay. And now we want to close both of these. So now we want to dive into the shape settings here. We have the all the settings for the separate shapes. So we go into the star settings and we can go for the star points. I'm going to take one away. And then for the inner radius, I'm going to just bring that up a little bit and the outer radius as well. And then I'm going to kind of pucker it. And then bloat it a little bit, very subtly. So we have a star like this, looks cool. All right. Now in the secondaries, what I want to do is enable them and go to the position and also go for random, the speed pretty low. And we are going to make a little bit of a movement here. We're going to do the same thing for the opacity here. So we want to go for a random and a low speed. And a little bit of a flicker in the opacity here. So just play around with the speed to have like that kind of star flicker effect. You can also go maybe for a randomized scale. So we have a little bit of a real star look. You can also go into the animate scale and also go for random lower, kind of play around with it a little bit to get something a little bit like this. Okay, so that's cool. I do want less amount and a little bit more speed. And I'm also going to take away this position animation in the beginning. So in the beginning, we're going to for a none. And there we go. So it just comes up and we have some kind of animation like this. And now what you can do is just hold Alt and drag one on top of this. Go to the motion and the effects controls, click on that. We can just maybe scale it a little bit down. And then move one over here. And actually this one is just too big in general, so I'm also going to scale this down here. Maybe 50. And this one like 10. And then we want to hold Alt and drag one on top of that. Click on the motion, we can move it around here. Alt and drag and just move them all over the place a little bit. Maybe make this like 20, and that way you get some kind of variation going on. And we have some stars. Just make sure that the text is on top of these stars so they don't kind of overlap on top of the text. So it's basically a regular layer system. I'm going to uncheck that. And now we have the combination of all these layers together. Now what we want to do is play with images. And now the most interesting part of this entire plugin, or essential graphic actually, but it's basically a plugin. I prefer, like, this is my favorite part of the animation builder. So if we go to the website, so we have to go to this specific link, smashworkshop.com/customizer, and then we get this page. So what we do here is actually load in one of the images. So the custom image motion graphics template, we want to drag this right here. And you see all these images here, and it's super easy to use. So what I'm going to do is open up another folder where I have some images prepared. I have this rocket and a few planets. So I'm going to drag this into the first one. And then I'm just going to fill it with my planets. And there we go. And then you can generate your own template using those images. So you can say, okay, this is our planets V2. I'm going to download this. There we have it. So now what I'm going to be doing is I go to Premiere, go to Browse, and import my specific one that I just created. So go to Custom Image. And just load planets V2, open that up. And now if I drag this into my composition again, I'm going to just disable all the other ones so we can see this in a little bit more real time. But basically everything goes pretty damn fast. So that's really, really nice as well. So I'm going to uncheck my interface controls and let's see. Okay, so we already have our rocket here because now it's image select one. So we have the first image selected. So I don't like that it's coming from the top. I want it to come from the bottom. So I'm going to set it to zero. I'm also going to set it to continuous right here. So it actually continues up and we have this kind of animation. Cool. The speed can be a lot less. So I'm going to just drag down the speed. Wow, we're really getting something here. And then next, what we want to do is go into the secondaries, enable them, animate the position, and maybe you want to go for random, and the speed we can keep it as it is, but just lower it quite a lot so we have some kind of vibration on that rocket. Okay, so that's really cool. I'm going to increase the speed and lower the distance here. That's so cool. Okay, so we have our rocket done. Now what I want to do is go back to browse, custom image, and just load it again because we're going to do something completely different. That's why I'm not duplicating it. So I'm going to drag this a little bit lower so we can see this one here. Again, I'm going to disable the interface and I'm going to go to number two. This is image number two. Okay, so I want to fade it in, or actually with the position, I kind of like it that it's coming from the top and maybe also with an overshoot. And then I'm going to click to the on the motion, set it to maybe 50 and like let it move in here and let's see. Okay, cool. So my planets are kind of dropping in like this. Hold Alt, drag it on top and let's select another one and then just move it over. Maybe make it a little bit bigger. Right over here, we can duplicate it again. Maybe 25 and choose another image. There we go. And put one over here, maybe 30. And one more. And there we go. Maybe 35. Okay, cool. So we have all our planets now. They're going to be animating in just like this. But what we can also do is just zoom in a little bit and offset each individual layer so it looks a little bit more dynamic. Cool. And now if we bring everything on here and we just like pre-render this section, we just created a super awesome animation inside of Adobe Premiere Pro using the Smashworks animation builder, which is just, I'm gonna leave this up to you. What do you think of this? Let me know in the comments below. All right, so that's it for this tutorial. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, give this video a like. Also be sure to subscribe to the channel for more and definitely hit the notification bell so you stay notified when I upload new videos. I hope to catch you guys and girls in the next one. Take care and goodbye.